Oh, she's the cutest, isn't she? I'm sorry, what do you mean she's 41? Hello everyone, and welcome or welcome back to my channel. I'm Odile, I work as an art director in the beauty industry, and I've been researching Korean beauty for many, many years now. On this channel, I make informative content on Korean beauty trends and history. So if you'd like to be the first to know about what's trending in K-beauty, don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications. When it comes to Korean beauty, many people seem to be fascinated by the fact that Koreans tend to look younger than their age. Unlike in Western beauty, where we rely heavily on strong active ingredients to combat the signs of aging, it's very rare to find this kind of ingredients in Korean skincare products. So how do Koreans achieve their youthful looks? Well, from what I observed, it comes down to two main factors. Number one, prevention. Most Koreans start to take care of the skin at a very early age, before they even start to develop the first signs of aging. Number two, protection. They put a lot of time and effort in protecting the skin from environmental aggressors. This means applying sunscreen every day to protect the skin from UV damage, as well as using skincare products that are loaded with antioxidants to protect the skin from free radicals. In this spirit, in today's video, I want to talk about the most powerful ingredient you can find in Korean skincare. It's a native Korean ingredient that can help you slow down the skin aging process, boost your skin's natural defenses, and even reduce the appearance of fine lines. Ancient Koreans used to call it God's gift, but nowadays it's simply known as Korean ginseng. I'm using the term Korean ginseng instead of just ginseng, because Korean ginseng is a particular variety of ginseng that is recognized by the World Health Organization as the ginseng with the most medicinal properties in the world. The thing about ginseng is that it's a very delicate plant that only grows in certain climates and certain conditions. And Korea, thanks to its unique geographical position, represents the ideal growing environment for ginseng. Researchers found that Korean ginseng contains more than twice the amount of active ingredients of other varieties of ginseng. And for this reason, it's considered to be the finest ginseng in the world. The scientific name of Korean ginseng is Panax Ginseng, a name that is derived from the ancient Greek panakeia, which means all healing. This particular name is due to the fact that ginseng has so many health properties that in the past it was used as a remedy to treat all sorts of medical conditions. But what is it exactly that makes Korean ginseng such an incredible healing plant? Researchers found that the health benefits of Korean ginseng are due to the plant's high concentration of active ingredients. The most important compounds you should know about are called saponins. Saponins are chemical compounds that are naturally found in plants. Their main function is to protect plants from external aggressions and bacterial infections, and clinical studies show that they have a similar effect on humans as well. When ingested, saponins improve the human body's immune system. They combat free radical damage, lower cholesterol levels, and protect the body against cancer and leukemia. When they're applied to the skin, it was observed that saponins have the ability to protect and strengthen the skin's barrier. They also improve the elasticity of the skin, lighten dark spots, calm down irritation, and reduce the appearance of fine lines. For this reason, Korean ginseng is one of the few natural ingredients that is recognized by the Korean FDA for its anti-aging properties. The reason why I said it's important to know about saponins is because the effectiveness of Korean ginseng depends on the amount of saponins it contains. I mentioned this in a previous video, but not all varieties of ginseng are made equal. Some types of ginseng contain a higher quantity of active ingredients, and it's really important to understand the differences between each type before buying a skincare product that contains ginseng. The first aspect I want to talk about is the difference between wild ginseng and greenhouse ginseng. Wild ginseng grows naturally in the mountains, absorbing all the minerals and nutrients found in the mountain soil. For this reason, researchers found that wild ginseng contains up to 10 times the amount of active ingredients found in cultivated ginseng. As a result, wild ginseng is a lot more pricey than greenhouse ginseng. Just to give you an idea, the average price of wild ginseng in Korea is around $2,000, whereas the average price of cultivated ginseng is around $200. So next time you're about to buy a Korean skincare product that contains ginseng, keep in mind that products that contain wild ginseng are more effective and expensive, whereas products that contain cultivated ginseng are less effective but more affordable. But how do you know if a Korean product contains wild ginseng or cultivated ginseng? Well, there are two Korean words that I think is worth learning. The first one is insam, which means cultivated ginseng, and the second one is sansam, which means wild ginseng. The second aspect to consider are the age of the ginseng plant and how it is processed. According to these factors, we can identify three varieties of ginseng. First, we have fresh ginseng, which is a type of ginseng that is less than 4 years old. This ginseng contains a very small amount of active compounds. It doesn't have any medicinal properties and is mostly used as a cooking ingredient. Next, we have white ginseng, which is harvested after 4-6 years and then peeled and air-dried. White ginseng contains a lot more active ingredients than fresh ginseng, but it was observed that it tends to lose some of these compounds during the drying process. Lastly, we have red ginseng. Red ginseng is not harvested until the plant is at least 6 years old. It's not peeled but steamed, which causes the ginseng plant to change color. This steaming process dramatically increases the saponin content of ginseng, which is why red ginseng is considered the most potent ginseng currently available in the world. This might seem a little bit too technical, but I believe it's really important to understand these differences before buying a product that contains ginseng. Sometimes I saw ginseng products sold at stupidly high prices, and when I checked the back of the product, I discovered that they only contained greenhouse ginseng cultivated for a couple of years. And I find that this is pretty common, especially when it comes to Korean beauty brands that are more focused on selling their products out of Korea, because they can easily take advantage of the fact that Korean ginseng is an ingredient with a great reputation. But not many people out of Asia know that there are different varieties of ginseng and that they all have different properties. Having said that, I want to show you some ginseng products I find quite interesting. Ginseng is one of my absolute favorite skincare ingredients, so some of the products I'll show you are longtime favorites I've been using for many, many years now. Other products have been recent discoveries. Some of them I liked, others not really, but we'll get to that later. The first product I want to show you is the 1899 single essence from Dongyinbi. If you grew up in a Korean household or if you like hanging around Asian supermarkets, you might remember one of these boxes. Those ginseng supplements are produced by the Korean Ginseng Corporation, which is the oldest and most reputable ginseng manufacturer in Korea, and they're widely recognized for being one of the best ginseng manufacturers in the world. In fact, they received so many certifications and awards that I don't even know which ones are worth mentioning. Dongyinbi is the beauty brand launched by the Korean Ginseng Corporation in 2013, and all products from the brand contain their award-winning ginseng. This essence in particular is one of my top 2 favorite essences of all time. It contains nothing but a single ingredient, and that is 100% of pure white red ginseng extract. The thing that really won me over when I first tried this product years ago was how silky and smooth this leaves my skin. If you look at the texture, you can see that it's super watery and that the skin absorbs it almost immediately. So at first I thought this would be the classic hydrating essence with a light formula that disappears on your skin after a few seconds, but that's absolutely not the case. I'm not sure how exactly they did it, because this essence contains a single ingredient, But this product right here makes my skin so velvety and smooth like no other product. It's simply mind-blowing. I consider this one of my top 2 favorite essences of all time because it's the kind of product I always reach for whenever my skin feels under the weather. It's a revitalizing product in the true sense of the word. It brightens the skin, it makes it more elastic, and in general, it gives you this healthy glow that is truly beyond words. Next, let's talk about the new repair serum, Ginseng plus Snail Mucin from Beauty of Joseon. Did you notice anything on the packaging? The Korean name of this serum is Insam Snail Serum. So from the things I said before, you can already tell that this product contains cultivated ginseng as opposed to wild ginseng. Plus, there's no indication of how old is the ginseng used in this product, which is not usually a good sign. I recently received this product to review, and at first I was really skeptical because I already knew that it didn't contain the most active form of ginseng. But if you have been following for a while, you might remember that I generally quite like Beauty of Joseon. So in the end, I decided to keep an open mind. I must say that I like how the formula feels on my skin. It's very hydrating, but it's not as sticky as you would expect from a product that contains snail mucin. I've been using this for some time now, and I noticed that it did lighten the dark spot left by a breakout I had recently. But I think this was mostly due to the fact that this serum also contains some skin brightening ingredients like niacinamide and licorice root extract. In terms of anti-aging properties, I didn't notice any major effect. Maybe it's because I usually prefer serums with a more active content of ginseng. But I could really sense a difference between this serum and the ones I used in the past. I think this could work for you if you're in your late teens or early 20s and you're looking for a preventive anti-aging product. Because this is really inexpensive and it contains some great antioxidant and skin repairing ingredients. However, if your skin is more mature, I think it's worth investing in a serum with a stronger content of ginseng. So I put together this list of my absolute favorite ginseng serums that hopefully you could use for some inspiration. I can't really pick a favorite among these three, but if I really had to, I would probably go for the Donghimbi one. When I get a new bottle, I will 100% make a video about it. Lastly, this is the ginseng cream from Suryohan. Some of you might remember I said the Ginseng cream from History of Wu is my favorite moisturizer of all time. In fact, many of you are probably sick of me talking about how great this moisturizer is. The main ingredient of the Ginseng cream is white ginseng, which is why it works so incredibly well when it comes to reducing the signs of aging. But the thing is, I know that this product is quite pricey. So this time I wanted to introduce you to a great alternative that is a little more affordable. Suryohan is the little sister brand of History of Wu. Both brands belong to the LG group and they're both based on traditional Korean herbal skincare. The difference between the two brands is that Suryohan is marketed to a younger audience. It still contains some premium ingredients, so their products are not super affordable. But they are not as premium as the ones used in the History of Wu products, if it makes sense. By the way, if you'd like to learn more about the traditional Korean skincare, I have a dedicated playlist on my channel that you can check out. This cream in particular contains a combination of wild white ginseng and wild red ginseng, so it has great anti-aging properties. The formula feels very luxurious on the skin. It's really rich and nourishing without the oiliness that usually comes with this kind of formula. I love applying this cream before going to sleep because it makes my skin feel moisturized and protected for a long time. In terms of anti-aging effect, this is not as life-changing as the Ginseng cream, but I can still tell that my skin looks visibly more plump and healthy when I use it. That brings us to the end of today's video. I truly hope that you enjoyed it, and if you did, please don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more informative content on Korean beauty. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.